Hi, my dear students. I am your Somshekhar sir from Kumadwati Science and Commerce BU College, Shikarika. In this session, I am going to present you the reported speech. My dear students, this question will come in your annual examination for 5 marks in the question number 27. Today, I am going to clarify all your doubt and going to teach you how to take out in the reported speech. Okay, let's get into the concept. Look at the usage. What is the meaning of the reported speech? We use the reported speech to report what another person has said, but not using the speaker's exact words. This is what we call reported speech. And the structure is a little different depending on whether we want to transform a statement, question or request. It's depend upon that, how to change the direct sentence to the indirect sentence. Dear students, if you want to change direct sentence to the indirect sentence or the reported speech, you need to know from sentence wise and the structure which sentence you are transforming to the reported speech. Okay, let's look into the sentence wise and some other rules here. Look at the one example. Ravi said, I am a good boy now. This is the one example of the direct sentence. So when we are transforming this direct sentence to the indirect sentence, before doing that, you need to look into the structure. Here, two parts are there. Ravi said, comma, this is called one part, and that part, particularly Ravi said and comma, that part is considered as like a reporting verb. And the double united comma is there, and there is a sentence is there. I am a good boy now. This and close the double united comma. This part is called as like a reporting sentence. Okay, this is the structure of the direct sentence. Ravi said, comma, that part is called as like a reporting verb, and which the sentence is in between the double ended comma, this part is called as like a reporting sentence. Look at, when we are transforming this direct speech to the indirect speech, we need to connect reporting verb along with the reporting sentence. So when we are connecting each other, what we need to use? We are using conjunction. We are using the connecting word, linkers. Here, by using the conjunction, we need to connect reporting verb and reporting sentence. For example, here, if I write this direct sentence to the indirect sentence, look here, it will be like this. Ravi said that he was a good boy then. Look at the changes, what I made here. One thing, Ravi said, I used the connecting word here. That is the connecting word I used here to connect reporting verb to the reporting sentence. Conjunction, I used the conjunction, one thing. And here, he was a good boy. And here, I am a good boy. Look here, the back shift of the tense. How I made? It is in the present simple present tense, I changed it into the simple past tense. He was a good boy now. Here is the now is there. I changed now into the than. So this is called time changes. This is the one example of the direct sentence to the changing the indirect sentence. Look into the some rules here. If the reporting verb, I told now that reporting verb, the sentence up to the comma, that is called reporting verb. If it is in the present tense or the simple future tense, no need to change the tense of the sentence. But you need to change the personal pronoun and the time. Okay, if the reporting verb, instead of said, if it is a says, so there is no need of changing or the back shift of the tense. Only you need to change the personal pronoun and the time. Look at the example here. Somu says, okay, comma, this is called reporting verb. The reporting verb is in the present tense, look here, says or will says, if it is a present tense or simple future tense. What you need to, don't change the back shift of the tense here. He is speaking with manager now. Okay, Look at the index sentence of the reported speech. Somu says that he is speaking with manager than. Why I didn't backshift the tense here? Because the reporting verb is in the present tense. This is the one rule you should remember when you are dealing with the reported speech. Okay, look into the next one. So we need to learn the reported speech sentence wise, because it depends upon what the sentence we are transforming to the indirect speech, either the statement, request or order. Today in this class I am going to give you a detailed structure about the sentence and what are the things we need to follow if those sentences are in the direct sentence. Okay, in sentence there are 7 types of them. As for our second PUC reported speech concern, we are going to follow and learn the 4 major types of sentence here. One is assertive sentence, imperative sentence, interrogative sentence, and finally exclamatory sentence. And exclamatory sentences are rarely used in your examination. But don't forget it. You should recall and brush up your memory how to change the exclamatory sentence also. Okay, these are the 4 major sentences, and you need to learn how to change these sentences into the indirect sentence. So look at the assertive sentence. How to identify the assertive sentence, my dear students? This is very simple. The assertive sentence starts with the noun or pronoun and ends with the full stop. That is the easiest way to identify the assertive sentence. I'll repeat it. Assertive sentence starts with noun or pronoun and ends with full stop. That is called assertive sentence. Okay. So what are the things we need to follow if the reported sentence is in the assertive sentence? Look at here. If it is says to or say, you need to change as like a tell. Or sometimes it is remains as like a says or said. And if it is said to, we need to change as like a told. And if the reported sentence is the assertive sentence, we need to connect reporting verb and reported sentence. The conjunction we need to use here, the connecting word of the conjunction, that is called that. Look here, if the reported sentence is in the assertive sentence, we need to use the that as a connecting word to connect the reported speech and the reported sentence. Understood? And don't forget this conjunction. And for example, look here, I have taken the one example from the 2DL chapter. The criminal, apostrophe is there, colon is there, I will not run away. This will be the structure in your annual examination. It is understood the criminal told to the minister, or sent it to minister, that is understood, and that part is hidden here. Look how to change this sentence to the indirect or the reported here. Criminal told. Why I use the told here? Because this is the given sentence, is the assertive sentence. And sent to is here hidden. So if it is sent to, we need to use told as a verb. So criminal told ministers that. Why I use the that here? Because the sentence is the assertive sentence. Look at the sentence here, I representing pronoun here. It is started with the sentence started with the noun or pronoun and ends with a full stop. That is called assertive sentence. So I used that as a connecting word because this is the assertive sentence. The reporting sentence is the assertive sentence. That he would not run away. Look, will in the when we are reporting, change it as like a would, past tense, modal auxiliary. Later I will tell how to change all those things. This is the one example. How to change if it is a assertive sentence, if the reporting sentence is the assertive sentence, you need to follow this structure. And as for your syllabus concern, as for your second PUC examination concerns, they would like to ask you only the past tense. This is hidden things in this format. Said to is the hidden. But when you are reporting, don't write told to, write only told. If you write told to, that is wrong. You will be going to lose 1 mark. Okay? Look into the imperative sentence. Imperative sentence. How to identify the imperative sentence? Imperative sentence always starts with the verbs, action word, and ends with the full stop. That is the one way to identify the imperative sentence. It will be going to maybe order, request, suggestion, whatever it may be. Okay, look into the things what we need to do. If it is a imperative sentence, if the reporting sentence or the direct sentence is in the imperative sentence. Look, if it is says to change as like a tell or order or request or anything, depend upon the situation. If it is said to, it will be going to change as like a told, ordered, requested, suggested and questioned. It's depend upon purely situation. When they will ask the question in your examination, they will ask particularly from your textbook only, because you know the context. So depend upon that context, you need to take the reporting verb here. Okay, for example, I will tell you later. Look at the connecting word, what we need to do. If the reporting sentence is in the imperative sentence, use to as like a connecting word. To as like a connecting word. Got it? And most importantly, if we write the to in the sentence, then the verb must be in a V1. Remember this thing. Infinitive verb, to plus V1. Got it? And if the imperative sentence starts with the negative, like don't close the window, don't open the door. If the sentence starts with the don't, what we need to do? Use not to do as like a connecting word. You follow these two things and remember always. Okay, if it is a imperative sentence starts with the verb, use to as a connecting word. And if the imperative sentence starts with a don't, for example, don't close the window, don't open the door, use not to as like a connecting word to reported verb and reported sentence. Okay. Look here, one example. Doctor said to patient. Okay, that is up to your reporting verb. And look into the double ended comma. Take these tablets for 3 times. This is called reporting sentence. Look at the structure here, take representing action word. The sentence starts with the action words, ends with the full stop. That is called imperative sentence. Got it? Look, I applied some rules here. Doctor said to change it as like a suggested, because doctor used to suggest us. Take these all those things. Doctor suggested, if you write 2 here, that is wrong. Suggested only you have to take. Don't take unnecessarily 2 here. Doctor suggested patient. Here I took 2 because this is the connecting word. To take. Why I wrote take here? Why I didn't backshift the tense here? Because with 2 we always write V1. This is called infinitive verb. Infinitive. To take. This is changed as like a those. Those tablets for 3 times. So this is the one way of understanding the reported speech if it is an imperative sentence. Later I will give more example. Look into the next one. If it is an interrogative sentence which is going to questioning us. My dear students, in interrogative sentence there are 2 types of them. One is yes or no type of sentence and another one is WH sentence. Interrogative means which is questioning us, or we are going to questioning someone else. So here, take an example in the beginning of the first yes or no type of sentence. How to identify the yes or no type of sentence? The yes or no type of sentence always starts with the auxiliary verbs, are also called as like a helping verbs, and ends with the question mark. This is the one way to identify the yes or no type of sentence. Okay, and the WH sentence. Now it is very easy. The sentence starts with the WH word. Who, where, when, how much, how many, and ends with a question mark. So that is the easiest way to identify the WH sentence. These 2 sentences are considered as like a interrogative sentence because these 2 sentences are questioning us. Look at the things what we need to do if it is a yes or no type of sentence. Look at here. The says to or said to change as like a ask and asked. If the question mark is there in your direct sentence or the direct speech, take the verb asked as like a reporting verb. This is the one and only reporting verb if it is comes in the past tense, and if it is a present tense, take as like a ask. Okay, here the connecting word. There are two connecting word are there if it is a yes or no type of sentence. One is if and the another one is whether. And if is used most probably 99%. Whether is used very rarely. Later I will tell where the whether is going to use in the reported speech. And most importantly here, if the reported sentence is in the interrogative format, especially yes or no type of sentence, what you need to do when you are transforming the direct sentence to the indirect sentence, you need to convert that sentence to the assertive sentence while transforming the direct to indirect. Got it? This is another one thing you should follow. Look at the one example here. Pranavi said to Anchal. Okay, Pranavi said to Anchal. Up to here, this is called reporting verb. Look at the double quoted comma. Will you come to college tomorrow? Question mark. So here, will representing helping verb. At the end of the sentence, there is a question mark is there. Okay, so this is the one example of the yes or no type of sentence. What is the answer for this question? Either maybe yes or maybe no. That is why it is called as a yes or no type of sentence. Look at the transform. How to transform and how to write the direct to indirect here. Pranavi asked. Why I took the asked here? Because this is yes or no type of sentence. Question. Asked answer. Look here. I changed from yes or no type of to the assertive. What is the easiest way to remember the assertive sentence? The sentence should start with a noun or pronoun. So here, you changed as like a she, because Anchal is also a girl. She would, will change it as like a would here, would come to college the following day or maybe next day. Both are acceptable. Tomorrow may be translated as like a following the day or maybe the next day. Both are acceptable. Any one you may write here. So Pranavi asked Anchal, she would come to college the following day or maybe next day, first off. So this is the transformation of the yes or no type of sentence. Here we left if or whether. What we need to fill here? Whether to fill if or whether. Here we need to fill if as a connecting word. Look here, Pranavi asked Anchal if she would come to college the following day or the next day. Okay, here why I wrote fill the if here correctly, because it is a questioning sentence. If the sentence is not so questionable, there you need to use whether. Later you come to know that one. Here you need to fill if. That is why I left here. I didn't type here for telling these things itself. So if is the suitable connecting word here. And look into the next one. For the example for the WH question. Paramesh said to Uma, who are you? Who are you? Question mark is there. Here the sentence starts with the WH word and ends with a question mark. How to transfer this one? If it is a WH sentence, there is a one rule is there. Take the same given WH word as like a connecting word to connect the reporting verb and reporting sentence. Look at here. Paramesh asked Uma, and I took the connecting word who itself, who she was, and changed the questioning sentence to as like an assertive sentence, starting with the noun or pronoun. Who she was, first off. So this is called WS sentence. To remember, my dear students, if it is a WS sentence, take the helping verb which is given in the question, the same word, WH word itself. For example, here, who are you, they gave. And I took the same word, who, as like a connecting word in between for a reporting verb and reporting sentence. Look here, Paramesh asked Uma who she was. Here, I took the if. So many students are getting confusion what to take, whether to take the if or whether. If you are getting confusion, don't make it lot of more. Write both if or whether. There is no problem. But where to use the whether? Look at the next slide. Use of if or whether. Word order like statement, since they are not really questions. Okay, not really questions. In these type of sentence, you can use whether instead of if. Okay, now you understood why I left the blank there, why I left the connecting word, why later I told the if is the right connecting word, because of that. That is a questioning sentence. If it is not so questioning sentence, use whether as a connecting word in between reporting verb and reporting speech. Got it? This is the usage of the whether and if. Go to the next one. If it is an exclamatory sentence, says to and said to changed as like an exclaim and said to change as like an exclaimer. Here most probably we are using the connecting word between a reported verb to reported sentence, that is called that. Here there is some trick is there. For example, look here. Example, Shreya said to Tanu, "Wow, it's a beautiful flower." So how to identify the exclamatory sentence? Exclamatory mark will be there. It is the easiest way to identify. So when we are changing this direct sentence to the indirect sentence, we need to follow some structure. First, what we need to do? We need to convert that exclamatory sentence as like a simple assertive sentence. Then we are going to transforming that simple assertive sentence as like a indirect speech. So here I convert this exclamatory sentence as like a assertive sentence. That is like this. It is a beautiful flower. Okay. I remove the interjection who and the exclamatory mark, and I wrote it in a simple assertive sentence. It is a beautiful flower. Okay, converted. Then I changed this sentence, the converted sentence, to the indirect speech. Look here, make the assertive sentence to indirect now. Shreya exclaimed Tanu that, connecting word that, because it is an assertive sentence, that it was a beautiful flower. So here, backshift of the tense happened. It was a beautiful flower. You might get confused which tense, where we need to change the tense, how to change, backshift the tense. Don't confuse. Look into the changes, what we need to do when we are reporting. This is the example of the exclamatory sentence. So when we are narrating from direct to the indirect, we need to change time, we need to change place, and we need to change personal pronoun. Look at the chart. Now changed as like a then, today changed as like a that day, this week changed as like a that week, tomorrow, the next day, or the following day, yesterday, the previous day, last week, the week before, or the previous week, here changed as like a there, this changed as like a that, these changed as like a those, we changed as like a they, and I changed as like a me, mine, he. So personal pronoun changed depend upon the situation. Okay. Who is speaking? Whether the speaker is a female or male or third gender, it depends upon the situation. So these are the things you need to change in the indirect sentence. If it is these things,
look at the tense changes. What are the tense we need to change in the reported speech? If it is a simple present tense, change it as like a simple past tense. If it is a present continuous tense, change it as like a past continuous tense. Present perfect tense, change it as like a past perfect tense. If the reported sentence is in the present perfect continuous tense, it should be changed as like a past perfect continuous tense. If it is a simple past tense, should have to change as like a past perfect tense. Past continuous tense changed as like a past perfect continuous tense. My dear students, do remember, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense, no changes. If the sentence is in this format, change only pronoun and time. Okay. These are the changes you need to make while changing the direct sentence to the indirect sentence. Okay. Look into the next step. Modal auxiliaries. If it is a will, should have to change in the indirect sentence as like a would, can change it as like a could, may change it as like a might, shall change it as like a should, must add to. Okay. These are the rules you need to remember while dealing with the reported speech. Look at the examples from your text which is oriented to your annual examination. Look at the example. So the question will be like in your question paper. Question number 27, report the following conversation. It will be asking for 5 marks. Each one sentence carries for 5 marks. So they will ask in this format, like a dialogue, conversation format. Okay, here, roof said to POP campaigner is hidden. They only ask for the dialogue, roof, colon, and you know my work for Marcus. Okay, there you need to understood, roofed to POP campaigner because you already knew this chapter, you knew this context, this situation. So they will ask in this format only, conversation format only. So, and most probably they asked only past tense. So said to is hidden. So according to the sentence, look at, this is called sentence, reporting sentence. According to the sentence, you need to take the reporting verb. That is why I gave detailed description about what to take if that assertive sentence is comes as like a direct sentence. If the sentence is in the imperative, what to take? If the sentence is interrogative, yes or no type of sentence, remember all those rules. Now apply here. Let's look into the one example. Proof. You know my work for Marker, POP campaigner. Marcus will not be there at the time of putting in your vote. Roof. Will it not be heard outside this room? And POP campaigner told him, we are after votes, not gossip. Roof. It will be very bad. So this is a 5 sentences are there in this conversation and it is all in the direct sentence. Now you need to change from direct sentence to the indirect sentence. You should write like this in your annual examination. Put the question number and answer. So it will be like this. And look at the changes what I need here. While you are writing in the annual paper, mark the, underline the changes what you made. Okay. Proof. Told. POP campaigner. I took told here because look at the first sentence here. Proof. You know my work for Marcus. This sentence is an assertive sentence. So, if the assertive sentence is in the reported sentence, said to change it as like a told. That is why I took told here. Okay, whom he told? Roof told POP campaigner. So that, because why I took that here, it is an assertive sentence. That he knew his work for Marcus. Okay, you know is there, changed as like a he, no. Simple present tense changed as like a simple past tense. New, my work changed as like a his work for Marcus. These are the changes I made in the first sentence. Underline for these words. And the second sentence, POP campaigner told to the roof here, Marcus will not be there at the time of putting in your vote. Look at the changes. And continue in your answer sheet like this. Put the full stuff and continue the answer here itself. POP campaigner told. Why I took the told here? Because this is also called as an assertive sentence. Told roof. That is a connecting word. I took here because the reporting sentence is in the format of the assertive. That Marcus will change it as like a would. It is a modal auxiliary. In the indirect sentence, it will be changed as like a would. Not be there at the time of putting in his. Look here. Your vote changed as like a in his vote. Full stop. So, underline for these changes. The backshift of the tense and the pronoun and the time. Underline for those things. And put a full stop. And continue here itself. Proof. The third one. Will it not be heard outside this room? Question mark. Look, the sentence starts with a helping verb. And at the end, question mark is there. This is a yes or no type of sentence. If the yes or no type of sentence is there, take the reporting verb as like asked. Look here. Roof asked. Whom he asked? POP campaigner. Okay. What is the connecting word we need to take here? If or whether. Here if is the right one. If you're getting confusion, write the whether also. If or whether. It would. Look here. Will it not be heard outside? It is a questioning sentence. Change that questioning sentence as like an assertive sentence. Beginning with noun or pronoun. Look, it would not be heard outside this changed as like a that room. Got it? That room. So this is the exact translation of this third sentence. Look at the fourth sentence. POP campaigner told roof. Look here. We are afterwards. It is once again assertive sentence. POP campaigner told roof that connecting word. We changed as like a they here. Look at the changes. We changed as like a they here. They were. It is R is there and it is changed as like a were afterwards, not gossip. Full stop. And the last sentence. Roof. It will be very bad. Roof told POP campaigner that it would be very bad. This is an easy example. Most probably here, I asked only assertive sentence. Okay, easy example here. Look into some other examples which comes and covers all type of varieties. Look at the another example from the Sunny Morning, which is your favorite drama in the second PUC textbook itself. Gonzalo, the gallant lover, look at the his dialogues. I am fond of good verses, full stop. And he continued his dialogue. I composed some in my youth. Two sentences are included in one dialogue. Remember how to change those things. And Laura, were they good ones? Question mark. Here, yes or no type of sentence is there. Gonzalo, why do you ask me such question? WS sentences is there. And Laura, don't be angry. So what? Imperative negative sentences are there. Don't be angry. Look at the changes how to make here while you are reporting the sentence. Okay. Gonzalo told Laura that he was fond of good verses. He was fond of good verses. Look at here. I am a fond of a good verses. Change it as like a he was a fond of good verses. Simple present to simple past. And he continued that dialogue. Here, instead of Gonzalo, I wrote he told directly because it is understood. He told Laura itself. Okay. He told that he had composed. Look here. I composed some in my youth. It is in the simple past tense. That should be changed as like a past perfect tense. He told that he had composed some in his youth. Look at the changes. His youth. My youth changed as like a his youth. Then full stop. That is the end of the first dialogue. Full stop. Then continue the answer. Laura asked Gonzalo. Okay, Laura asked Gonzalo because it is a yes or no type of sentence is there. If or whether is the connecting word. If is the right one here. But if you are getting confusion, write that whether by putting the bar. Otherwise, don't write that one. If is the right one here. If, look here. Were they good ones? Change it as like a they had been good ones. If they had been good ones. Were representing past continuous. So past continuous changed as like a past perfect continuous. That is why it is changed as like this. If they had been good ones. Understood? Good ones. Full stop. Gonzalo asked Laura. The next sentence. Why do you ask me such question? Gonzalo asked Laura. The connecting word is given the WH word is the connecting word. Why? She asked him such question. Why she asked him such question? Look at the changes. I use the connecting word, the same given word. Why is the same given word and I used the connecting word here? The same given word here. Asked Laura why she asked him such questions. Full stop. And the last sentence. Don't be angry. Here, look here. This is a negative imperative sentence. If it is not ordered, if it is not suggested, if it is not requested, if you are getting a confusion, if it is not all those things, use told as a reporting verb. Here, don't be angry. It is not a suggested. It is not a requested. So that is why I use told here. Look at here. Laura told Gonzalo connecting word. If the sentence starts with a don't, use not to be as a connecting word. Not to be angry is the next sentence. So continue these answer in your answer booklet. Here some changes happened because of the mistake of the PPT. Continuity. Make continuity. It should be start with here itself. Okay. Don't write like this. Continue the sentence by putting the full stop. Look into the another example from the Sunny Morning itself. Petra. The guard is waiting for me. Laura, do you like to chat with your guard? Petra, he is not mine. Laura, wait a moment. Petra, what does Senora wish? Here, look at the changes what I made. Petra told Laura that the guard was waiting for her. So, is waiting is changed as like a was waiting. To me, changed as like a her. The second one, Laura asked Petra, if she liked, look here, do you like to chat with your guard? Do representing simple present tense. It should be changed as like a simple past tense. I removed all these things and changed assertive sentence very simply. If she liked to chat with her guard, okay, here your guard changed as like a her guard. Petro told Lara that he was not her. Look here, he is not mine changed as like a he was not her. And she continued. Lara told Petra, look at here, wait a moment. Wait started with the action word. This is the imperative sentence. If the imperative sentence is in the direct sentence, use to as a connecting word. Look at there. Lara told Petra to wait a moment. To wait a moment. That's it. And Petra asked Lara, look here. Petra asked Lara, what does Senora wish is there? Now this is does is representing simple present tense and it should be changed as like a simple past tense. What Senora wished, that's enough. Okay, what Senora wished, that is enough. Just changed from simple present tense to simple past tense. Look at the another one example, the last example. Lara, you should have asked permission to sit on this bench. And the next dialogue, Gonzalo, the benches here are public property. And Lara told, why did you complain about the priest then? And Gonzalo told, are you taunting me? And Lara told, don't grumble. So, like this, this is a perfect pattern to write in your annual examination. As like this, you need to write. Here, what I change the color, you need to underline in your annual examination. What you are going to change in the indirect sentence. So, look at here, the exact translation of that given reported speech. Lara told Gonzalo. Okay, why I took told here? Because the first sentence is the assertive sentence. That is why I took told. And I took the that because assertive sentence, first sentence, started with a noun or pronoun. Look here, you representing pronoun. That you changed as like a he should have asked, should already representing past tense. That is why I didn't change have and I didn't change asked also. Okay, after using the one past tense in the sentence, there is no need to change the next verbs. Should have asked permission to sit on this bench, changed as like a that bench. Okay, this bench changed as like a that bench, full stop, and continue the answer here itself. Gonzalo told Lara that, look, the second sentence, the benches here are public property. It is also assertive sentence. That is why I took told here. Gonzalo told Lara that is a connecting word because it is an assertive sentence. Started with the noun or pronoun and end with the full stop. The benches here changed as like a there were public property. Okay, are changed as like a were. They were public property. Full stop and continue the answer. Lara asked Gonzalo, look into the third sentence, why did you complain about the priest then? This is a WH sentence. So questioning sentence. If the questioning sentence is in the reported speech, you should take asked as a reporting verb. Look at here. Lara asked Gonzalo why he had complained about the priest then. Look here, why did representing simple past tense. So simple past tense should have to convert as like a past perfect tense. So here Lara asked Gonzalo why he had complained about the priest then. So V3, had plus V3 is the formula of the past perfect tense. Friend, I took the same word which is given in the question paper. The same WH word I took as a connecting word here to connect the reporting verb and reporting sentence. And the next sentence. Are you taunting me? Gonzalo asked. It is also yes or no type of sentence. Gonzalo asked Lara if she was taunting him. Look here, are you taunting me is in the present continuous tense. It should be changed as like a past continuous tense. And you need to backshift the tense along with the convert the yes or no type of sentence to be assertive sentence. Look at the changes here. Gonzalo asked Lara. If she is a connecting word, she was, look here, assertive sentence, she was taunting me changed as like a him. So these words you need to underline in your annual examination. The last line, Lara, don't grumble. Lara told Gonzalo not to grumble. My dear student, these are the examples which may come in your annual examination or not. So here, what you need to do, look at the example of this once again. In your annual examination, put the question mark number and write like this, one after one by putting the full stop. And most importantly, what are the changes you are doing in the reporting speech, underline for that. Like this, I color the words here, underline for that. Okay? If you are following these steps very neatly, without failing, definitely you are going to taking out in this sector. Okay? Don't forget to remember all these rules. Okay? And learn with the sentence wise. It will be very easy to deal with the question, whatever they might be asked in the annual examination. Okay? Thank you very much, my dear students. If you like the video, please hit the like button. And if you didn't watch the 10 series, I'll give a description in the description box and the link in the description box. Go through with all those videos. 10s are the foundation for this. Watch it. And if you have any doubts, comment me in the below comment box. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.